If aliens came to Earth and told you you needed to select one musician or band to represent Earth in an intergalactic singing competition, who would you pick? They have to be alive. They're representing humanity, not just you and your weird tastes. Also, if their song can't prove to the rest of the alien community, which includes sentient bags of gas named Ursula, zombie viruses that make great lattes, and assorted murder-sauruses, that humanity has a shred of sentience, emotion, feeling, all of that stuff, we are all getting wiped out. Who would you pick? Well, you are not being given that choice, and according to Catherynne Valente's comic science fiction novel Space Opera, that is a very good thing because you would be wrong. The best choice, according to the last aliens to have made it through this gauntlet, would have been Yoko Ono, but since neither she nor the hundreds of others of human musicians more suitable for alien tastes were available, the task falls to Decibel Jones and the Absolute Zeros, who have split up, had a third of them die, and have not produced anything worth listening to in years. So this book is great because it takes the premise, what if Eurovision, but in space, and uses it to explore ideas of identity, how we know who we are, along with piling in interesting weird aliens and technologies and cultures. The book owes a lot to Douglas Adams, but the language is complex and lyrical as it spins its cotton candy. So, like, I sometimes get bogged down in Catherynne Valente's words in her other books, but Space Opera is basically pure glamorous joy, and I loved it. So, yes, if you are lamenting the deaths of Prince and David Bowie and don't mind science fiction that isn't really rigorous in its application of the word science, you really should give Catherynne Valente's Space Opera a read. Maybe get in the mood by YouTubing some Eurovision finals. See what humanity has to offer. Okay, thanks very much.